Hello, welcome to day two here at the Bio CEO and Investor Conference in New York City. With me right now is RJ Tesi, CEO at INmune Bio. RJ, great to see you again.
It's a pleasure to be here.
The last time we caught up with INmune was with your CFO, David Moss. That was back in April of last year. He had mentioned that you'd begin enrolling patients in your Alzheimer's study by midsummer. Can you kind of update on the progress since then?
Sure. I think there's actually been three big events in the company since the summer. Two are really directly related to the company, and one is kind of indirect. So we have started enrolling the patients in the Alzheimer's trial. That is rolling along very nicely. It's a very novel trial in that it is a precision medicine biomarker-directed trial, which makes it unique in the Alzheimer's world. And as an aside, I think this is really where Alzheimer's disease research needs to go. Those clinical trials look more like cancer trials, where we use biomarkers and precision medicine than kind of all-comer trials, which has been one of the problems in the past.
Problems in the past, meaning those large pharma companies who have failed with those.
Absolutely. And today there was just another announcement that a amyloid-based therapy failed. That's not the first time it's happened. But I think, you know, not only are there questions about the target, amyloid, but I think there has to be a little more thought going into clinical trial design. I mean, the oncology clinical trialists have been very, very innovative about the way they design their trial. And the net result is that patients benefit. Because when more drugs get approved, patients have more options, outcomes improve. That's where we need to be with Alzheimer's disease. And I like to think that INmune Bio is leading the charge on that.
So. Well, you do have some credibility now because you did recently receive a grant. I think it was just yesterday.
Yeah, so actually it's we received from the ALS Foundation a $500,000 grant to study ALS. ALS is another one of these neurodegenerative diseases that's been tremendously frustrating for clinical trialists. We like one of the kind of quips we make in the business all the time is that thousands of mice with ALS have been cured, but no patient has ever been successfully treated. So it's a disconnect between the fact that the clinical models aren't that good. I think there's some problems in maybe some basic understanding of the disease, similar to amyloid versus the Alzheimer's story. But we applied for and won this grant, and it really sets us up for potentially taking our X-Pro 1595 that we're using to treat Alzheimer's disease into the ALS area. We're actually pretty excited about it, but cautious.
Well, you're also expanding your kind of portfolio of therapies to enter the NASH space, which is, talked about this before the interview, becoming trendy in the biotech space.
So that's interesting. We've actually had, you know, I was a liver transplanter in my previous life, so I know a lot about cirrhosis and fibrosis and NASH. And we've actually had these NASH data for 3 years. And we've been really trying to decide whether we should enter the field, because the field is large, complicated. There are well-financed players in the field. And quite honestly, as a small company, we had our hands full with our immuno-oncology and Alzheimer's programs. But over the summer, as you know, it was kind of like there was the steady drumbeat of programs failing. And we really like our asset. I think we have a very novel approach to treating the disease. We finally decided to throw our hat in the ring. And so, yes, now we are probably the only company in the world that does cancer, Alzheimer's, and NASH. It's a very unusual combination. But the combination doesn't seem that odd if you step back and look about how we're going about it. Obviously, we believe that innate immune dysfunction, or the innate immune system, is the source of many of the problems related to chronic inflammation. Chronic inflammation has kind of become trendy. You didn't see anything about it in the newspaper before Thanksgiving, and since Thanksgiving, you begin to see more and more about it. And chronic inflammation is very different than acute inflammation. Acute inflammation helps us survive. Chronic inflammation is killing us. And it's part of a fundamental bit of biology, such that it's involved in cardiovascular disease, neurodegenerative diseases, metabolic diseases such as, you know, obesity, diabetes, and NASH, and the list goes on and on. So we're taking a single therapeutic strategy, which is targeting soluble TNF, and we're putting into these multiple therapeutic areas. It's pretty exciting. It's very unusual. It requires some education to investors because they think we're being quite ambitious, which we are. But at the end of the day, I think we're going to make a difference at the bedside.
So. Well, I'm looking forward to following your progress, RJ. Yep. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It was a pleasure as always.